Everybody excited? Yeah. Awesome. All right, I'm very, very excited to be here again. Today, I'll be focusing on two main topics. We're talking about how we're going to be empowering you with the AI building blocks that you're going to need to build the next generation of your apps. We'll also take a look at how we're looking at AI to bring it to help you build applications a lot faster. Let's start talking about those building blocks. Now, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. Creating AI-driven apps isn't hard. The true challenge lies in building effective and reliable AI apps. To do that, you need a secure, well-integrated stack, a stack that has a data access layer for retrieving data from multiple places, an execution layer for automation and performing tasks and logging events, a reasoning layer for making decisions powered by large language models, a learning layer for self-improvement, and obviously a security layer to ensure safe AI operations. Now, the good news is that we've got decades of experience delivering a secure and well-integrated platform. And as Giuliano mentioned, last year we laid the groundwork with features like support for vector embeddings and semantic search for both text and images. And we've seen how many of you have taken advantage of those to create some really amazing user experiences. But as we continue adding new building blocks into the fold, we need to make sure that they all come together again in a secure, integrated, and easy to administrate fashion. And that's why, with the introduction of FileMaker 2025 later this year, we're introducing a new tab in the admin console called AI Services. This tab will simplify managing all of your new AI tools. Now, I'll take a couple of moments to show you some of the new AI tools that you'll have at your disposal. Let's start with the obvious one, large language models. Here, you'll be able to easily download, manage, and host the models of your choice directly from the admin console, giving you the choice to decide how you want your deployment to be, whether you want to go full cloud, on-premise, or a hybrid approach. So maybe you have a cloud model for marketing email, right, to generating marketing emails, or use a local model to analyze sales data. Now, a concern that we hear often from you is that these models don't understand the nuances of your business or industry. And that's why we're including the ability to train your own model with fine-tuning. We're also including a retrieval augmented generation or RAG server. With fine-tuning, you'll be able to train the model of your choice to be able to speak about your business using your own terms. And with the RAG server, you'll be able to turn the mountains of documents and unstructured data into data that the AI can use to answer your questions. Combined fine-tuning and RAG server will help you turn the years of data that you already have into a competitive advantage that you always knew it would be. So now that you have the model that you want, how do you access it? Well, obviously, you can, and many of you have, use the integration capabilities of FileMaker, like the insert from URL script step, to bring the power of large language models into your apps. But let's be honest, you still have to learn a new API, curl options, and parsing the data, and error capture, and much more. Now, since integrating large language models into your applications is a crucial component in the reasoning layer, we've created a new script step that simplifies and streamlines this process and makes it easier than ever before to bring the power of LLMs into your apps. And I'd like to take a moment to show you just how easy it's going to be. Now, I call this demo Zero to LLM in 60 seconds. That's right, if you blink, you just might miss it. Now, I have a simple application here with just a few fields. There's no scripts and just a button that I'll define. Now, I'm going to go into the button, and I'm going to have it run a script. Now, there's no script, so we're going to create one from scratch. The first step is to configure an AI account. We'll give it a name, whatever we want, because we'll just use it as a reference. Then I'll choose the provider, whether it's cloud or on-premise, and the API key that we'll be using. I'm just going to pull it from a field. Now we'll add the new script step, generate response from model. We'll reference the same account. I'll choose the model that I want to send this to. And then the information I want to send, the prompt, which will be coming from a field. And now I'll choose where I want to store the response track from the model, which will be another field. And just for fun, I'll turn on streaming, because I just think it looks cool. Go back into browse mode, click on the send button, and we got a response from the AI. So in just a few simple steps, we've gone from zero to fully functional LLM integration. Now, I don't want you to think that the script is just about making it easier and faster to bring LLMs into your apps. There's more to it than meets the eye. We've actually built some superpowers into it. For example, we've given it the ability to store and manage the conversation messages, making it easier for you to create chat interfaces. We've also integrated with web viewers to make it very easy for you to create really dynamic and amazing user experiences. But one of the things that I'm most excited about is that it also has an integrated way to leverage the ability of LLMs to use tools. Here, you'll be able to take your own custom functions and scripts and make them available to the AI so that it can complete more complex tasks. Now, you can execute these yourself. You can script them yourself, or you can have FileMaker execute them automatically for you in agentic mode. Now, of course, always adhering to the security and access privileges that you define so the AI only has access and can do what you allow it to do. Now, I'd like to take a moment to share with you a quick demo that we put together to illustrate what might be possible for you to create when all of these features and the already existing features of the platform come together.
Hey there.
Hello. How can I assist you with your customer relationship management app today?
Well, to be honest, to get a better understanding of our sales pipeline, I need to see the number of opportunities per deal stage. Think you can help me with that?
Here is a breakdown of the number of opportunities per deal stage in our sales pipeline. If you need any more details or further analysis, feel free to ask.
Actually, yeah, this is pretty interesting. Do me a favor, create a bar chart with this data.
I've created a bar chart depicting the number of opportunities per deal stage. Let me know if there's anything else you'd like to explore.
I'll be honest, this was really, really cool. Would you be able to create like a sequence diagram showing me exactly how you did this?
I've created a sequence diagram showing the process of how I generated the data and chart. Let me know if you'd like to delve into any other areas.
Well, that was very helpful. I'll tell you what, I do need to do more analysis, but I don't know the database schema very well. Do me a favor and show me a diagram of our tables and the relationships between them.
Here's a diagram of the tables and their relationships within your database schema. This should help you understand the structure for your analysis.
Actually, this does. I'd like to see how many sales agents we have per regional office, please.
Here's the number of sales agents per regional office. Let me know if you'd like to explore anything else.
Well, this is really great, but I just remember I'm going into a meeting now, and I need some sort of company performance report. You think you can help me with that?
Absolutely. I've prepared a company performance report for your meeting. It includes the top three accounts by revenue, top selling products, and top salespeople by opportunities won. If you need more information, feel free to let me know.
This is actually going to help a lot. I will be sharing this report with our Latin America colleagues. Can you please create another copy of this report in Spanish?
I've created a Spanish version of the company performance report for your Latin America colleagues. You can share this with them. If you need any more assistance, just let me know.
I think that'll be all for today. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
I hope you can see that combined with the already powerful and flexible features of the Claris platform that you know and love, and the release of FileMaker 2025 later this year, you're going to have all the building blocks you're going to need to create the next generation of your apps. Now, if you're interested in learning more about these features, I'll be hosting a session later today where I'll be diving into some of these features and some common use cases. Additionally, I'll be crashing the party at the Getting Started with Claris FileMaker and AI Training Day session with a slightly deeper dive into some of these concepts. And if that's not enough, we've got a whole bunch of other AI sessions by some of my colleagues that you're not going to want to miss. Combined, all of these sessions will give you the opportunity to learn and explore how you can bring AI into your own projects. So now that you know that you're going to have all the AI building blocks that you're going to need, I'd like to shift gears and talk a little bit about how we might be using AI to help you create apps faster. Now, as everybody here knows, developing in FileMaker does not happen in a text editor. As a matter of fact, it doesn't even happen in just one place. Right? We've got to define database and security, layout mode, script workspace, and a lot more. So there's a lot of places where we could apply AI to help speed development process. But when I think about, you know, having AI help me develop a lot faster, the first thing that comes to mind for me is the calculation editor. One of the things I love most about FileMaker is that it enables me to repeatedly leverage the skills that I learn. And I think the calculation dialog exemplifies this perfectly. The calculation editor is a cornerstone of FileMaker. It appears just about everywhere in the product. We spend a lot of time there, so it makes sense for us to start there. So imagine, if you will, having an AI-assisted tool that helps you generate complex expressions quickly and accurately. Now, a quick disclaimer, what you're about to see is a prototype. So the final product may evolve, and some features could change or not be included. With that out of the way, that being said, I'd like to give you a sneak peek at some of the things that we're cooking up in our labs to help bring AI into your hands to help you generate calculations a lot faster. So I have an event solution here that I'll use to demonstrate how we might be doing this. And I'll start with a simple example. Let's say that I want to set up the auto enter value for a field to be the date in 2 days from today. So as I go into the calculation dialog, you'll notice that on the right-hand side, I have an AI-assisted tool. Now, I'm going to write in plain language what I want, which is the date in 2 days. Just like that, the AI not only generates the correct expression, but it also explains how and why this works. This is incredibly valuable, especially for those who are new to the platform, as they get exposed to new functions, operators, and how they all come together. Let's look at another example. I have a status field over here, and I also have a value list called task status. Let's say I want the default value to be the first value of that value list. Again, I'll just, in plain text, get the first value of that value list. And once again, the AI generates the correct expression, but it also gives me an explanation of all the functions and how all the pieces of this expression all come together. There's more. Let's move out to the layout. Now, I have a button bar segment here that's a delete, and it's showing up in find mode, and I don't want that, right? So I'm gonna go into the hide object when, and I want to ensure that we hide it when we're in find mode. So I'm just gonna type it in there, just validate that the user is in find mode. Now, this expression might be simple for most of us, but let's be honest, who can remember which number is for each mode? Now you don't have to, right? AI will ensure to create the correct and an accurate expression for you. Now, I spend a lot of time in the data viewer. It's one of my favorite places, especially for calculations. So let's look at a little bit more complex example. I do a lot of formatting of data. So let's say I want to format the data of a field as a phone number. Once again, the AI is able to create the correct expression, but also breaks down this more complex expression into each one of the parts, explaining how all these pieces come together to give the correct answer. Is that cool or what? Now, obviously, we're looking at other ways and other places that we can bring AI to help speed up your development process, but I wanted to share that with you here today. So, to recap, first we saw how we're bringing the AI building blocks that you're going to need to create the next generation of your apps. And you got a sneak peek at some of the things that we're looking at and how to bring AI to help you speed up your development process. Now, before I leave, I want to give a special thanks to the AI ETS members, many of whom have met with us on a weekly basis for over a year, making sure that we build the right things the right way. So thank you.